Hello. Today I'm going to talk about all the viral diseases that are so prevalent these days in this weather. How should you take care of your children and of your own self in this season? What are the various kind of viral illnesses that are more prevalent in this year? As you know that different years and different seasons will have different kind of diseases, and every year the kind of virus that circulates presents in different ways. Like this year, a lot of viral illnesses, at least where I live in North India, what I am seeing is that the virus is causing a low grade fever, not very high grade, and also that there is a little bit of a sore throat and cough in this season among many school going kids, and other cases we have seen and have interacted with other doctors also to know their concerns in the OPD, what kind of viral illnesses are caused. So what can you do if your child is suffering from a viral illness? What will be usually presenting in the child? Child can be lethargic, he can complain that he is tired very easily, he may be coughing. There can be a sputum seen in the cough or nothing at all, it can be a dry cough. They will usually have mild grade fever, sometimes it can be high grade, very high fever also. So all these things, and especially the seasonal change that we are noticing in this season, children are more prone and also adults are more prone to get viral illnesses. So what can you do? What is your first line of defense to prevent? Yes, we will talk about prevention first. In case you and your kids have not yet suffered a viral illness, what can you do to prevent yourself from this viral illness? So the best form of defense that you can have is that avoid places which are very crowded, which are very congested, because a lot of pathogens will be there in the air and you can contract an illness in such places. If your child is not really feeling very well, then don't send him to school on those days, because their immunity might be a little compromised, and when they go to a class and if some other child is sneezing, then they can easily catch that cold and flu virus from their school. The third important thing that you can do is to build up your child's immunity, because as you know, a good immune system, a good defense against the infections which are prevalent, gives us a very good fighting tendency against the pathogens. So how can you build up this immunity in your kids? It's very simple. The child has to be always well rested. You cannot have a child who is very active and playing full day and not getting any rest at all. So a well rested child, sleeping at least for 8 to 10 hours in the night continuously uninhibited, a good nap time in the afternoon, giving them lots of warm drinks, like you can give them haldi water or tulsi water, a little warm. Even in their milk you can add haldi, it is a good antibacterial, antiseptic, and turmeric, tulsi, pepper, black pepper, and haldi and ginger. All these are adaptogens. So adaptogens are basically substances which help form a good immunity, a good line of defense against the pathogens. So prophylactically you can start giving them a little bit of tulsi and adrak, or give them warm water, or in some form of the other you can introduce these things in their diet that can help prevent against the viral illnesses. In case you notice a little bit of a sniffing or a cold, you can always start giving them prophylactically. You can give them ginger and honey during bedtime. Still, if the child is getting viral illness, then just take care of the child. Antibiotics is really not needed. All you need to do is ensure that their body is well hydrated. That is, they are taking enough fluids. Give them lots of hot soups. Don't give them very cold stuff. Give them hot soups, hot lukewarm water, and lots of warm nourishing foods like khichdis, and which are easily digestible by the kids' stomachs. Even for adults, the same rules apply. Take lots of soups and hot teas to prevent yourself, and also the cure is also the same. to cure yourself from this viral illness. In case the temperature of the child is very high, if it is less than 100 degree Fahrenheit, there is no need for giving them any medicine. You can simply do sponging of the child and bring down the temperature. In case the temperature is very high, then always consult a doctor and give the medicine which the doctor prescribes for lowering down the temperature. Otherwise, it is just home-based care, lots of love, lots of support to the child. Sometimes if the child is having a lot of congestion in the chest and sneezing, then an anti-allergic and also lots of steam inhalation and lots of nebulization is also needed at times. So all those things, kindly get in touch with your doctor and start the therapy. Otherwise, happy monsoon, happy all the festivals which are coming in this season. Happy Navratri. Hope you guys have a lot of fun and the kids don't fall sick at all, the adults don't fall sick, and all our immunities are strong enough to fight this season.